Air. I hope it's clear and sunny where you are.
And the computer says the skies are clear, but looking out the window, I know it's lying.
Hey, but the computer, you know, everything on the internet, it's the truth. It's got to be.
It's got to be factual.
If it's online, it's got to be the facts, you know? It has to be. So.
But that's where Tom's propaganda comes from, so.
That's right. I'm going to rename this Tommy's Packer Propaganda Show. WSUM 91.7 FM, Madison, Wisconsin. Get a little punchy here. Getting ready for the big ball game tonight, 7:15 NBC. Be there. Packers against the dreaded Chicago Bears. You know, it's going to be a game. You know, I can sit there and tell you it's going to be 35-3. Well, I won't give him three, maybe zero, but it's
going to... Wow, it's getting worse.
It's going to be a tussle because they're going to have to play. This is their season, man. You know, if they go 1-4, it's...
How many interceptions does Brian Griese throw today?
I don't think he should throw. I don't think they should throw, and I think they really messed up by pulling Grossman out. They really should have kept Grossman in. I mean, that's just ridiculous.
Well...
It's not just Grossman.
I think they lot of it's Grossman. Well, no, it's not just Grossman because their defense is awfully banged up this year, too.
Ball control.
Well, you can't control the ball when you're throwing interceptions.
Yeah, well, you know, it's I don't know.
Rex just doesn't have a brain. Well, I'm just going to say that.
It's like Lovie Smith got in all the politics, like watching the polls. You know, he needs to be more like President Bush. Stay with this. Stay what he believes, not going by the polls.
You know what? That actually helps the Packers out, too. Put Grossman back in. Oh, my God. Put him back in.
But, you know, real coach, you don't go by the polls. And don't worry about everybody's worrying about what they think. Forget that. They should have kept him in.
That's not really true, though, because he stuck with Grossman for a long time. And they've been hating on Grossman for probably... 2 years now, two full seasons. I mean, it's kind of tough to tell with Rex because he's always hurt, or he was early in his career. Now they wish he was. But I don't know. I think maybe Kyle Orton might be the answer for a couple games here.
Yeah, he did a pretty good job for a lot of years.
Well, yeah.
When that 1 year when he played.
Yeah. He's more of a game-managing quarterback, so they're kind of shying away from him, and we got more music. What did Tom find now?
We got that Fox theme. In the background. Keep going, buddy.
What it is. Okay.
Yeah, Fox
anyway.
Terry Bradshaw, you know.
Okay. You got to bring up Terry Bradshaw. Okay, our street cred was kind of hovering right about here, and it just took a dive with Terry Bradshaw. Anyway, Kyle Orton is a really good game manager as far as that goes. I mean, he's not going to put up a whole lot of stats for you, but... That's not really what they need right now. They just need somebody who's not going to throw two interceptions or three interceptions a game. I mean, Greasy threw two last week. Grossman's usually good for at least three of them. So, I mean, in that respect, I guess it's an upgrade.
Again, listen to the polls, worrying about everybody says. But I'll tell you one thing, that Grossman, this is where he really got my goat. Speaking of goat, Billy Goat, got my goat is
the Cubs.
Last year against the Packers on New Year's Eve.
Oh, that was awesome.
I know. But Grossman, he was silly enough to tell everybody, well, I was thinking about what I was going to do tonight. Because they moved that game from like noon to like 7 o'clock on NBC. Yeah. So he comes out after going, well, I was thinking about what I was going to do. You just, even if you're thinking that.
I told you.
You don't say that.
He does not think, ever. He doesn't think on the football field. He doesn't think at a press conference. He just doesn't think.
Well, I don't know. Well,
and you know what the scary part was? Coming out of Florida, the Packers were in position where they could have drafted him.
Really?
And a lot of people were saying that the Packers should draft him because they were drawing a lot of comparisons to Brett Favre because Grossman's got a really strong arm and he has a similar style in the pocket. And much like Favre in his younger days, he also doesn't think very much.
Yeah.
But there you go. Favre always had the talent to bail himself out when he didn't think. And Grossman, obviously not so much.
You know, the quarterback position, it gets, you know, a little bit too much criticism, a little bit too much praise.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot more going on out there for the Bears than just him again. And I remember sitting there, I think Grossman, like 3-4 years ago at opening day in Lambeau Field, he took us apart.
Yeah, he did.
So, but they had everything going. They were able to run the ball, defense, Devin Hester, and again, well, I guess I'm glad they pulled him now. So get him out of there, put Greasy in.
No, I'm not glad they pulled him. I want him back in there. I think it gives them a better chance to lose.
No, they're just doomed. They really are doomed. I'm sorry. We got no Chicken Bear fans. Give me a call. You know, I tell you, I walk around the street with my Packer jersey on. They get on me because I got a Packer jersey on.
What hey, you're sporting the Brew Crew today.
I know. That's because I've been wearing my Brett Favre jersey for the whole week. So I figured I better wash it today.
Switch it up a little bit.
But yeah, you are listening to Bucky's Packers. Tom Garrett, your crazy propaganda Packer host here. WSUM 91.7 FM, Madison, Wisconsin. Your UW student radio. And my buddy Brandon. Brandon host here. We are looking at 9:52. Got about 8 more minutes rocking and rolling here in the show. We're going to come up with some more good jams here. We got a lot of sports stuff here in the station. And a lot of good music. So guys, always hang in there. Listen to us. 91.7 FM on the Madison Dial, or if you're on the World Wide Web, wherever you are in the world or the universe, you can listen to us at www.wsum.org.
Exactly.
Brandon, can you pull the station in where you live?
I can't, actually, because of the way that the tower is positioned.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually aimed back toward campus, and when I'm at home, I can't get it.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, it is actually... real easy. Just go online, go to WSUM.org,
mm-hmm.
Right there, live feed all the time.
Click it. Matt Rockwell, our technical engineer, doing a great job with our website, keeping our station always rocking and rolling here. You know, we got 5,000 watts of power out there in Madtown, so that's a lot of power for Tommy's propaganda Packer show here. I kind of like that. I'm going with that.
Oh, no.
Because it is a nut house.
Oh, no.
It is a nut house. So,
what have I done?
You've done a lot. Hey, you know, speaking of another team this week, in just case my buddy Eldridge is on the net out there. Uh-oh. Eldridge, you guys are 2-2. The Raiders are in first place.
Yeah, how about Dante last week?
Oh, yeah, pointing to his knee. I like that little shuffle you did with the hand stings when you came on the sidelines.
Yeah, I'm glad that Dante can actually go and kind of resurrect himself here.
Yeah.
I mean, I couldn't stand the guy when he played for Minnesota, but he's out of there now, so, you know.
He was good, man. You could never tackle a guy.
I know. Granted, he has small hands and drops the ball a lot, but he's also huge.
Yeah. Well, that's another team up there, the Vikings. If they had some kind of quarterback, I heard last night on the show that, I think it was a McCarthy show, some Packer player was saying that was the hardest, that was a smacking game they had up in
Yeah, it always is. Those guys, for as long as I can remember, always go for the ball.
Yeah.
One of them wraps up, and they always go for the strip. I mean, even in the Super Bowl years, hated going up to Minnesota because you could never get a call up there, and they always went for the ball.
Yeah, you know things are really going our way this year because the other years after we fumbled the ball with less than 2 minutes to go, then we came back and got the pick. God sealed that victory for us.
Yeah, and I mean, that's so huge, too, because you look at the last 2 years. I think 2 years ago when they went 4-12, there were four games that they very easily could have won. And it was, they lost by less than a touchdown, and that came with probably less than 8 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. And then you look at last year, there were a couple more that they could have won. Granted, they won the last... the last four? Yeah. Because they were 4-8 after mm-hmm. they lost to the Jets, so they won the last four. And, you know, the first 12, you look at that, and there's at least two more that they could have won. So it's finally good to see that the breaks are going our way, and that's the sort of thing that you need when,
mm-hmm.
when you're going to contend. I mean, you got Dallas down there that's doing everything right and destroying everybody, but Green Bay's not quite there yet as far as the experience on the field. And, I mean, you look at these guys that are really young, and you think about the talent that they have and how good they can be by the end of the year, but they need that experience. And right now, we need those breaks to go our way.
Yeah, no, those last week, those two touchdowns by Brett, where there was just zings, especially the second one. I mean, the record was awesome. But the one that he threw on the sidelines to Jones, that was just reminiscent of Freeman in the Super Bowl. That was just a rope.
Yeah.
That's my favorite pass of the year so far.
Guy can still throw. Oh, go figure.
Gosh, you got to put that baby in there.
What day is today? The 7th?
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Yeah, so Favre's going to be 38 this week.
Oh, is it the 10th, I think?
On maybe. The 10th, yep.
The 10th. Well, happy birthday out there, Brett. 38, and as we were duly informed on the show before, George Bland went to his 49. So, Brett, you got 10, 11 more years to play.
Ouch. He's not going to be able to walk if he does that.
Oh, man. It would be like Jerry Rice. He'd be at like probably 700 touchdowns at that time. And
wow.
Half a trillion yards. And
half a trillion yards.
Maybe 500 interceptions, too, but that's okay.
Oh, yeah.
You know, bring it home. So you are listening to WSUM 91.7 FM. Tom Garrett's here in host. Brandon, my buddy, in studio. Bucky's Packers, it's 9:58. Time for us to rock and roll out of here. We got to set up for our next rock and roll show coming here in town. So, again, go Pack. Get everybody get fired up. Get your game jersey on. Play your Packers songs. Get your family together. Ladies, make some food for the guys. Set it up. Get the grills going. Bust it out. Don't worry about the game, Bucky. We'll be okay next week. Taking on Penn State. Your boy, Joe Paterno there, buddy.
Oh, men's hockey starting next week.
Too. Men's hockey. So
I'm not acknowledging Joe Paterno.
There we
men's
go.
Men's hockey starting next week in Dayton.
Men's hockey, our Lady Badgers out there. We are rocking and rolling. So, again, thanks for listening. Go Pack. See you next week. Rock and roll.
Town. This is David, a.k.a. Swingin' Richard from the worst band in the world, saying, yahey dear, for cripe's sake, you're listening to Bucky's Packers, featuring Tom Garrett on WSUM 91.7 in Madtown, Wisconsin, for cripe's sake. You betcha. Now let's get this tailgate party started.